Welcome back to HB Unfiltered Sports Talk. I'm joined by the Stiff Brownie, the Intern, and the Dirtbag. Today's show is brought to you by J3 Supply for your hose and fitting specialist. Come on down. Great guys. We're also pumping out some good ones here with First Class Pizza, OC Boardroom, Aloha Grill. Thank you for your guys' support. Also, gotbackup.com. And I want to give a quick shout out to Selman Chevrolet, who has my truck, because my transmission took a shit. And you better do a good job and take care of her. I don't want a piece of crap when I get it back. All right, with all that being said, I need to take a break because I'm already starting to sweat and get pissed off. So we're going to go to the Intern and find out what happened this day in sports history.
Yeah, so in this week in sports history, a lot happened. In 1960, Muhammad Ali wins the Olympic light heavyweight boxing gold medal at the Rome Games. 1973, Hank Aaron sets records for the most home runs in one league, 709. 1985, Pete Rose ties Ty Cobb with 4,191 hits. 1994, Miami quarterback Dan Marino throws 5 touchdown passes in the Dolphins' 39-35 win over New England, setting the NFL record with his 18th game of 4 or more touchdown passes. 1994, San Francisco wide receiver Jerry Rice catches 2 touchdown passes and runs for another score in the 49ers' 44-14 rout over the Raiders, surpassing Jim Brown as NFL's career touchdown leader with 127. 1995, Cal Ripken Jr. breaks Garrett's record, playing in 2,131 straight games, which had stood for more than 56 years. 2000, we have Scott Sheldon of the Texas Rangers becomes the third player in MLB history to play all 9 positions in one game. And in 2001, Barry Bonds of San Francisco becomes the 5th player in MLB history to hit 60 home runs in a season.
Awesome. Wow. That, I think our listeners, just on what the Intern gave us today, should tell you how exciting this time is of the year.
Yeah.
We have so many sports that are going on now. We have the NFL back. We got college football. We still got the end of baseball and the World Series playoffs. We got MLS. I mean, Messi. Shit, he's exciting.
Yeah.
Let's just add that to the mix. You got Verstappen in the Grand Prix going for 11 on his next run. We got the end of golf just happened. I could keep going on. Oh, we got basketball and hockey right around the corner. So we got a lot of sports, but most importantly, let's talk about the NFL, Tim.
Well, can I say something real quick?
Sure.
About Cal Ripken. You heard that story that streak almost didn't make it, right?
No. Okay. Why?
Well, Cal Ripken Jr. was actually, at the time, Kevin Costner was filming Field of Dreams. He was living with Cal Ripken Jr. Cal Ripken Jr. forgot either a glove or his cleats. As he had left, forgot a glove or cleats, went back to his house for this specific thing, found Kevin Costner sleeping with his wife. Calls them, tells them, the Orioles, tells them, hey, this is 100% validated. It's all true. Calls them, and he's like, either the game before or 2 games before the streak, like, is going to happen. Calls him and says, I'm not coming in, obviously personal reasons, blah, 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 blah. So that night, they end up doing a power outage, and the game doesn't get played. It gets postponed to the next day, and then the streak continues.
Wow.
Or 2 days later.
Wow. I have never heard that.
Yep, there's a little inside info.
Kevin Costner, you dog.
He is a dog.
What a loser.
That is true.
He was just in court this past week.
Yep. Doesn't want to pay his ex-wife anything.
Yeah, the ex wouldn't even look at him, supposedly. Now I know why.
He's only made a kajillion dollars off of Yellowstone, but he doesn't want to give her any of the money. It's like, come on, dude, you live in California.
Oh, my God. That story's now throwing me for a loop.
All right. Well, you want to do a quick thing on baseball since we're talking about baseball?
Yeah, let's keep it going with baseball. Do you want to get back on the Angels? By the way, follow us on YouTube, and you're going to hear something about this one. Angels train wreck.
Yep, it is a train wreck. Artie, I don't know what you're doing, but you're now in the territory of Al Davis, where you were once great for the franchise. You're now ruining the franchise.
Yeah.
You don't trade Ohtani. Trout just went into your office yesterday and asked for a trade to either Philadelphia Phillies or the New York Mets. Rendon won't talk to the media. I'm not sure why that is, because he's collecting a paycheck that's way more than what he's worth.
He's definitely stealing.
You pick all these guys up at the trade deadline, which were crap, give all your farm guys away for crap, and then release them because, or put them on waivers, I should say, because you want to, you don't want to hit the luxury tax, which you still miss by like $2 million, so you're gonna have to pay it. What the fuck is going on over there?
Dude, I swear to God, I've never...
You guys are Barnum and Bailey right now. It's a freaking circus.
I could be a better GM without any experience. Hands down.
And this GM's supposed to be really good.
Wow.
I don't know what he's doing, but when you have your two superstars going to dinner together and deciding not to come back... There's some serious issues with that.
And I'll tell you what, I wasn't there, but I'm telling you right now, Otani was speaking English to Trout at the table.
I absolutely
believe
that.
While they were dining.
I absolutely believe that.
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean, your superstar wants out, and that's the face of your franchise and the face of Major League Baseball before Otani showed up. So,
yeah, they're not going to get anything for Otani.
It's sad times for sure.
But yeah.
On a brighter note, we are on fire with our baseball picks.
Yes.
This is now 4 weeks in a row that you have to have made money on taking what I was telling over the weekend.
Absolutely.
So I'm going to
give Mariners hot.
Hot.
Mariners are going to win the division.
Yep, they're hot. The games I love this weekend are these series. I like the Dodgers at Washington because they are hot. I love Atlanta at home against the Pittsburgh Pirates.
Yeah, they're hot. They look good against the Dodgers, huh?
Yep.
Jeez.
Yep. They put the Dodgers in their place.
I'll tell you what, though. I'd rather lose regular season games if I'm the Dodgers to the Braves and then win the playoff games.
For
just
sure.
Just like what they did to the Padres last year.
Yep.
They won every game in the regular season and lost in the playoffs. So just win the playoffs.
I agree. The last two teams, I love Toronto at home against Kansas City. Obviously, Kansas City's been a dumpster fire all year. But
yeah.
Toronto's playing really good baseball right now. So, and then Texas at home against Oakland. We all know that Oakland sucks. So,
man, Texas has really sucked themselves, though.
Yeah. They're
giving up double digits, like, every game. They got, I think, swept by the Twins. Now they're getting just pulverized by the Astros. Yesterday, Altuve, first three innings, three at-bats, three homers.
Yep, you're correct. That was Major League history.
Yeah, the guy's like 5'7", weighs a buck 60 wet. How do you hit so many home runs when you're that small?
And the last thing you need to look at, and I can't tell you which games to check this out in, but the day games that are being played in the Midwest that have starting pitchers over the number 55, they're a AAA call-up, they're going to get shelled. Take not only the team that they're playing against, but take the over, and you'll make some money.
You know what that's called, Stiffy?
Winning?
It's called batting practice.
Yeah, that's exactly what it's called. So,
they're technically games, but it's really batting practice.
There's a huge difference. Even the bad teams in Major League Baseball, the Major League Baseball players, there's a huge difference between the AAA and the Major League guys.
Yes.
And the stars are going to make their – they want to get – especially if you're like out of Kansas City or Oakland, you want to hit your incentive packages. So they're out there swinging because they want to get that extra home run and that extra $1 million. So they're still playing for something, the elite pros that have the big contracts.
Well,
so
if you want to watch a AAA team, just go out to the Big A, because they gave away all their players on the cheap on the waiver wire, and now it's all AAA players, and they're losing every game.
I heard it's similar to the San Diego Sports Arena back in, like, the late 80s, early 90s, where you could actually buy a ticket and walk all the way down now, and you can basically sit in Diamond Club for, like, $10.
Yeah, normally the intern, she goes to a lot of games. She's a huge Angels fan. She picks and chooses the games she wants to go to, but now she's a season ticket holder. And she sits right behind home plate, and gets wined and dined in the Diamond Club.
She has a good follow on Instagram. She's jet setting everywhere. She's in some sort of ritzy, fancy spot.
It almost looks like she's in two places at one time.
Do you have a job?
I do have a job.
We're not going to go there.
All right, well, that's enough about baseball. Let's get into the really good stuff, football season.
Let's start with college football.
Yeah,
How awesome was that to see Colorado snap their 19-game losing streak against teams in the top 20. They finally beat a good squad. I mean, not a good squad. TCU was in the national title game last year. And yeah, I know they lost their running back, receiver, and quarterback, but you know those teams. They recruit. They have just as good as players beneath them. And his son, Sanders, just came out slinging. 39 of 47. He only missed 8 passes, and a couple of those were actual drops. He threw for 510 yards and five touchdowns.
What I found very impressive is not only does he put the ball like right on a dime for his players, but when you're able to roll TCU, you have 87 transfers. That's how good of a coach Deion Sanders is.
That's amazing.
You have 87 transfers, and you get them all to collectively play as a unit in your very first game of the season, and you're playing TCU.
Yeah.
It's not like TCU's Portland State, like when Oregon played and won 84-0.
Right.
I mean, that was incredible. That just goes to show you how locked in Deion Sanders is about proving that he's a great coach, besides being an amazing player himself.
You know, what's funny is I always thought Lincoln Riley was the transfer portal king. It is Deion Sanders. How you basically got rid of that whole football team and revamped it in a couple months and got them up and running and to win a game. And a lot of those kids are FCS players, you know, from Jackson State.
Sure.
And Hunter, he played both ways, the receiver and cornerback, had a pick. Had 120 yards receiving. I mean,
do you know that his Heisman odds went from plus 8,200 down to plus 2,200?
Yeah, I saw
after one game, just because he's a two-way player and he's a super stud.
I saw that, and I saw both of Colorado and USC's upcoming schedule. It looks like they're going to meet when they're both about 6-0.
Yeah,
it's going to be awesome.
I love,
and it's
swagger.
In Colorado.
I love the swagger, and then on top of it, because obviously Deion is Deion. He's allowing all these cameras into the locker rooms.
Yeah.
And his pregame speech, I would have ran through a wall for him.
Right.
I was like, oh, my God, I'm getting chills right now thinking about it. I'm like, dude, this guy is a beast.
Yeah, yeah, unbelievable. Hey, I do want to make a point out. We were talking earlier on our two-minute rant on Instagram about how the Pac-12 would schedule better non-conference games and they'd go anywhere and play anybody. Well, on a side note, the SEC has always been the opposite. They don't even like leaving their state. Florida just for the first time played at Utah. It's the first time since 1991 that they played out of conference outside the state of Florida.
Wow. Well, that's why all those teams, once they get to the conference, they're all 4-0 and ranked super high. But they're playing, like, who are they playing?
Southeast Missouri State.
St. Mary's of the Blind. You know, all that.
St. Mary's of the Blind. You know what you're getting into when you play them. They can't even see.
You got a route going on. But
come on.
But, yeah, that Colorado team was fun to watch. A game was great. Obviously, this weekend was so much fun. I was in Vegas for it, just watching game after game after game. It was good times, so.
Yeah. Sorry. By the way, we're sorry we didn't have a show last week. Stiffy B had to get his gambling on. So, so how'd that go, by the way?
Oh, man, it did not go good.
Okay, all right.
Mandalay Bay was not very nice to Stiffy B.
Damn you, Mandalay Bay.
But I'll go back to Bellagio next time where I always play and win and make up for it.
Okay. So. All right, well, let's move on. Let's move on. NFL starts this Thursday. First game, we got Detroit Lions at Kansas City. Is Kelsey going to be okay, by the way? You drafted him in a couple of your drafts.
I did, yeah. The fantasy football gods are not shining down on me right now.
I wonder when they ranked you 9th in your fantasy league picks, if they took that into account. Because that might put you 12th if he's out for the year.
Well, I know that I had one draft at Caesars in the sports book, and Stiffy B had a few. And that team is a hot pile of trash.
How many are you in?
I'm in 5 leagues, but only 3 that I really care about, and one of them happens to be like my friends and family from back, like here in Huntington, and we're all kind of spaced out over the U.S. a little bit. But it's a fun league. But I can't win, no matter what. I can't win, and I just really drafted a bad team.
Well, you got to lay off the liquor, drink, get your team, and then drink.
That might have been a lot of Crown Royal picks, for sure.
Oh, man.
But you know what I won't do? I won't do what the Angels did, and that is get rid of their entire team after trying to get away.
You're watching the Heisman commercial, and you pick Barry Sanders
and Emmitt Smith
and Billy Sims as your running backs.
Oh, for sure. But, NFL, what do we like this season? Who do we like?
Well, I'm going. I like the 49ers because I think the NFC is just weak. I mean, obviously Philadelphia is going to be good, but it's all going to be on that young defense from the University of Georgia.
Right.
If they can hold up. So we'll have to check that out.
So you think the 49ers are going to be the ones that are in the Super Bowl?
Yes, I do. I think the 49ers get to the Super Bowl. Now, I'm not saying they win it, but I think they'll face the Buffalo Bills.
Ooh.
And if we talk about how you script things in life and, you know, letting Tom Brady beat Kansas City when he had no right beating them, or Kansas City beating Philadelphia because they had a rookie coach, rookie this. Well, they feel bad for the 49ers because of that quarterback situation. I think they're going to be back into the Super Bowl, and the Buffalo Bills have been shit on since the 90s. So I think both of them get in, and whoever wins, actually, it'll probably be the Bills because they've never won.
Buffalo Bills right now are plus 800 to win the Super Bowl.
That's a good pick.
And your San Francisco 49ers are, as I'm looking at
probably
it,
500?
Plus 800 as well.
Oh, yeah.
It's interesting.
Yeah, so I would go with 49ers Bills is my pick for the Super Bowl. What do you got?
I really like the Eagles. I like what the Eagles did in the offseason. I think they're going to be there.
Should we cut early?
I'm a fan of Aaron Rodgers. I want him to win, I would love him. Just the story of him sticking it to Green Bay by like, hey, I got out of that shithole, and now I'm going to win over here. That I would really like to see the Jets in Philly.
You know,
I know a lot of other people wouldn't care to see that, but
I would normally agree with you. I really do like what the Jets are doing, and I like what Aaron Rodgers is doing, you know, changing his whole persona and everything. But they have a tough, tough route. The AFC is loaded with teams. Cincinnati, Chiefs.
Sure.
It's going to be tough. But have a good weekend.
Cheers.
We're out.